One important matter that those circles of individuals who subscribe to the idea of so-called evolutionary creation ignore is the matchless forms of God's creation. God also created angels, jinn, and Satan with a very different creation other than human beings and animals. According to what we are told in the Quran, none of these entities came into existence as the result of a long process in stages through evolution. Rather, they were all created in a single moment, independent of natural causes, by God so willing. God is He who has no need of any process or long stages in His creation. In blindly clinging to Darwinist errors about the creation of man, some evolutionists offer no explanation as to the creation of angels, jinn, or Satan. Jinn did not evolve, but were created from fire at God's choosing. The creation of the angels is described in these terms and verses. Praise be to God, the bringer into being of the heavens and earth, He who made the angels messengers with wings, 2, 3, or 4. He adds to creation in any way He wills. God has power over all things. As can be seen from this verse, angels are very different in appearance to human beings. Indeed, God draws attention to this different creation in the words, He adds to creation in any way He wills. As revealed in verses 49 and 50 of Surat An-Nahl, angels are beings at God's command and were created before man. When God created Adam, the first human being, He informed the angels of this and commanded them to prostrate themselves before Adam. The Quran also refers to the angels of death, Gabriel and Michael, in the following verses. If only you could see when the angels take back those who disbelieved at their death, beating their faces and their backs, taste the punishment of the burning. Say, anyone who is the enemy of God, and of His angels, and of His messenger, and of Gabriel and Michael, should know that God is the enemy of the disbelievers. God informs us in the Quran that He sent angels to the prophets Abraham, Lot, and the Blessed Mary. The angels who gave the prophet Abraham the glad tidings of the prophets Isaac and Jacob entered his house with the word, peace. Those same angels informed the prophet Lot that his people would be destroyed. Verses in Surah Maryam reveal that God sent the angel Gabriel to Mary and that Gabriel told her, I am only your Lord's messenger. These messengers were brought into being alongside the prophets Abraham and Lot and the Blessed Mary by the will of God. They were created by the will of God, at the place and in the form chosen by Him. God does not refer to any process or evolutionary stages in these verses. These examples once again reveal God's matchless creative power and His creation independent of natural causes and stages. In the same way as that of the angels, the creation of man took place in a single moment, with God commanding him to be. No account of such miraculous creation appears in the works of certain Muslims who devote space to the outmoded deceptions of the theory of evolution in them. The angels were brought into being suddenly, without undergoing any evolutionary process. Like angels, the jinn's creation also differs from that of man. The verses show that man was created from clay, while the jinn were created from fire. He created man from dry earth, like baked clay, and He created the jinn from a fusion of fire. In the Quran, God also reveals His purpose in creating man and the jinn. I only created jinn and man to worship Me. It is clear from this that although man and the jinn are very different beings, they both were created to worship only God by living by the values He prescribed. God provides detailed information about jinn in the Quran, especially in Surah Jinn. They believe in God, they fear God, they submit to the Quran, they heed the Quran. In the story of the Prophet Solomon, related in the verses of Surat An-Naml, we are told that the jinn possess various abilities, such as that of transporting matter and moving very fast. As revealed in verse 119 of Surah Hud, the jinn will receive full recompense for their deeds on the Day of Judgment. Like the angel, the jinn were also created before man. When he created the Prophet Adam, peace be upon him, God commanded the angels and the jinn to prostrate before him. After that, he reveals that Satan is one of the jinn. When we said to the angels, "Prostrate yourself to Adam," they prostrated, with the exception of Satan. He was one of the jinn, and wantonly deviated from his Lord's command. "Do you take him and his offspring as protectors apart from me, when they are your enemy? How evil is the exchange the wrongdoers make!" God created the jinn from a fusion of fire. There is no reference in the verses to any evolutionary process, chance, or any evolutionary mechanism, because there is no question of the jinn being created through evolution. They were brought into being in a single moment, by the will of God, undergoing no process, mutation, or natural selection. Creation is an easy matter for God. Who creates from nothing and with no previous cause. Just as He created the angels and the jinn in different forms from nothing, He also created man as a separate being from nothing and with no need for evolution.